Hello, hello! Welcome back to my channel. I'm so glad you're back today because I want to talk about some new makeup releases because this is my upgrading my wishlist or not so much. I have selected a few, I think around 16 or 17 products I would like to talk about. I am trying not to put more than 16 or 17 products into these videos because they get way too long. And so I'm going to talk about 16 to 17 products I thought were interesting or not so interesting, and I'm going to see which ones I want to put on my wish list. I'm going to be on my phone because I want to be on the Trend Mood and Beauty News page on Instagram, and I'm just going to scroll through them, tell you what I think about the products, give you some information about release dates, prices, stuff like that. So, okay, let's jump right in, guys. Okay, I scooched over and I'm going to start with Tarte Cosmetics. Tarte Cosmetics have launched their fall collection, and it's called Fall Feels. And they say that this collection will have you falling for Tarte all... Is that N? Long, all along? Oh, as it never with endless bonfire looks. Well, okay, they have released a Fall Feels eye and cheek palette that is going to be $25 US. And Higgy and Kisses Start this remix lip gloss trio, and that is going to be $25. A limited edition Grown Paint Shadow Pot, that is going to be $22 US. And a limited edition Light Camera Lashes 4-in-1 mascara in $23 US. And I think that's an existing mascara, they just repackage it. And now it has this like almost Burberry type of a feel. I think it's, yeah, it's Tarte, it's very neutral. The colors in the palette is very neutral. I think that the glistening or the glitter pot, is it called? The limited edition Chrome Paint Shadow. I think you will have, if you use that stuff, you will have this color like 100 times over. So to me, this is not really that exciting. And I love that they gave it a Burberry kind of a feel, because I always think of Burberry for fall stuff. You wear the trench coat stuff. But yeah, no, this is not interesting enough for me, so I'm not going to put it on the wish list. And Too Faced. Too Faced, I'm going to have two things from Too Faced. I got it. They have launched their latest addition to the ever-growing Peaches and Cream collection. And it's going to be a Palm Springs Dreams Cocktail Party Eyeshadow Palette for $45 US. A Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray in a Peach Edition. That's going to be $32 US. And Better Than Sex Peach Edition. They do the same thing as start with their Better Than Sex Mascara. And that is going to be $25 US. And it's available now on Too Faced and Sephora website. And in stores, I would imagine. I don't think it's going to be in Holland yet, because maybe it's not even going to coming to Holland, but we will see. I think the palette is very basic. It's basic with a pop of blue, so yeah, it's not very exciting to me. It has some peach colors, it has some more neutral brown colors, some yellowish, more golden colors, I would say, and a kind of a coral or orange. What is it? I'm sorry. It's that Mocktail Room Tiki one. I think it's more of a orangey brown nude type of color. Totally not interesting palette. I'm sorry. I seriously don't get why they are releasing the same sort, the same look of a palette, and it just put a different name on it, put it in different packaging, and they say it's a new collection. I'm sorry, I'm not fooled. I must say that the Hangover 3-in-1 Replenishing Primer and Setting Spray in Peach is quite nice, because peach is a very nice smell. At least I think it is. And I think that the Peach Perfect powder from Too Faced smells really nice. So if it's going to be the same scent, then I think it's going to be a very nice setting spray. But I don't think I'm going to get it, because I've got a lot, and I think I currently have the watermelon one on my wish list. I haven't even tried that one out. I haven't even bought that one. So I'm not going to add anything from this on my wish list. And they have also sneak peeked their palette for holiday 2019. And some other stuff. It's like really, really cringy. And I have to say, it's all repeating the same shades. And to me, I don't get it. It's like they really have the same stuff and they just put it in different packaging. And yeah, you buy it, I think, primarily for the packaging. And I have a face palette from the Natural Face Palette, I think it's called. And I really am a sucker for packaging. So I bought it and the packaging is really nice. I think the products are really nice. But if you have one face palette or one eyeshadow palette, well, not maybe one eyeshadow palette, but if you have a few, then, you know, you have everything you need from Too Faced because it's all the same palette. It's the same again with this gingerbread, or what's it going to be called? Gingerbread Man, Hot Butter Face Palette, Hot Buttered Rum Eyeshadow Palette. That's what it's going to be called. And it's practically the same thing as I was showing before. It's just missing the pop of blue, and it's slightly toastier. So slightly darker than the Palm Springs one. Or the... Yeah, I think it was the Palm Springs one. So it's not drawing me in. You know, I have a lot of these colors already, and it's really about liking the colors versus liking the Too Faced formula and seeing if you would need something like this. But if you have some stuff from Too Faced, I would think you would have this a freaking million times over. So I'm going to move on. And I'm going to move on to BH Cosmetics. And no, it's not a Zodiac palette this time. It's an addition to their Take Me To series. And this time it's Take Me To Ibiza. And it's going to be $20. It has three face shades. And I think it's a very light bronzer and two highlighters. And then a lot of colorful small little eyeshadows. I think they're going to be as small as the Take Me To Brazil one. I have on my here. And I think the colors are pretty. It's not like, I think it's very on trend. You know, when I think of Ibiza, it's really like these colors, the nice turquoise blue and the soft jumping at you pinks, the very sweet pinks. And I think this is a very nice palette. I think it has really different colors from the Take Me To Brazil one. So I think this is a nice release. I am not mad at it. And I think that they put some nice greens in there as well. So yeah, you can really create a lot of nice looks with this palette. So if you are a fan of their formula, so then I think it's not a very bad thing to invest in. It's only $20. And of course, if you don't need it, don't buy it. But I think this is a good release. I'm not going to get it because I don't need these colors. I have a lot of these colors already. And I don't want to be redundant in my collection. And I don't even use my Take Me To Brazil one. I haven't used it at all and I've had it for months. So I think I have to use that one first before I'm going to buy anything else from BH Cosmetics or a palette like this. Then Lime Crime Makeup has released another Venus palette and is launching. Sorry, is it already here? Oh, it's the 9th of September. It's going to launch and it's going to cost you $38. And it's a very, very cool tone smoky eye palette. It contains 8 shades in 4 finishes. And you have matte, foil, shimmer and sheer shimmer. And I think that's more of a topper kind of a shade, the sheer shimmer one. I was a bit not confused, but I was a bit like, okay, is this something I want? Because it looks really different. You know, it's really, if you look at all the new makeup releases and you see it all on Beauty News or on Trendmood in their collage on Instagram, then it's all like warm tones, colorful, very bright, and then bam, there's this. So it's different. So do we want it now because it's different, or do we want it because it's nice and it's something we think is going to look good on us? Because I think that very cool tones, and I've seen, if you look at the swatches, I hope I remember to put on a photo of the, well, remember, I'm telling you now, Anneke, just put here the photo of the swatches. It's not that revolutionary. Dare I say it? I think the only color that is really intriguing me, because it's like a very deepish, almost oxblood deep brown, is that, what's it called? Oh my gosh, what's it called? Anvil. I couldn't read it, sorry. It's the Anvil color. That's the only color where I am like, wow, that is really cool, really different. I don't know if I can dupe that per se. I would have to look in my collection, maybe in one of the Anastasia palettes. So that's the only thing I am like, okay, that is so cool. But the rest, because I have Sultry and I have some, I think some loose eyeshadows that are very cool toned. I've got the Naked Reloaded that is cool toned-ish. No, I'm sorry, I'm not going to put it on the wish list. I'm not even sure if I really like it that much because I am not inspired to create a look with this necessarily. I think the brownish, the reddish brown with like the silvery taupey color would be really cool. But it's just one type of look I would create with this because the rest is not inspiring to me. So yeah, I think it's a very cool release because it's different and it's really stands out between the collage I told you about on Trend Mood and Beauty News page. It's really standing out, but it's not something I am going to wear, so I'm not going to put it on the wish list. Fenty has released a new brow pencil, and it's in 14 shades, and it's finally, I think, a very inclusive shade range for eyeshadow pencils, because there are like three very reddish, warm toned colors in here. So someone who has auburn red or more reddish red hair and eyebrow hairs, I think they would finally be able to find something that will match their hairs and their skin tone. And it also goes really, really light. And not in a very grayish light, but yeah, more of like a taupe-ish, very light brown type of light color. So I think very blonde and very fair-haired girls and boys can finally get their shade. So I think that is really, really cool. The tip is going to be very fine, they say. It's going to be retractable, and so you can really make those hair-like strokes with that. And they have a new type of brush at the end. It looked a little bit like the Artiste brush, but then in a smaller version. So yeah, I don't know if that would really work, because I really like the spoolie type of tool to brush through my eyebrows, because they spread your hairs a little bit better. And I don't know if a very dense brush is going to do that, but maybe it's going to be a very good thing to blend the product through your brows. So I'm holding off on that one until I see some reviews about it. It's not something I think I'm going to pick up or buy. It's just that I'm not really close to Fenty, so I have to go abroad to actually be able to swatch it in store. I may do that when I am in London in September, but it's not exciting enough to me. And I have nice brow products from Benefit that I really like and that are working for me, so I'm not going to buy it just because it's there. So yeah, it's not going on the wish list, but I think it's a very, very good release. Okay, then Milani Cosmetics have added 16 new shades to their lineup of Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 foundation. And their range now contains 45 shades in total. I have never used this Milani foundation. I've heard some great things about the quality of the product. So leave me a comment down below if you have tried it and if you think it's something I should try out. So yeah, that's just news that they've added to their range, and I think that's a good thing. So yeah, I wouldn't know if the undertones and stuff are good enough, but at least there are more shades now than there were. Then next up, Huda Beauty is going to release two products, or have they already? No, it's an upcoming launch, and they are going to release a live liner, and it says that it's going to be the ultimate life proof super matte eyeliner that's long lasting, 48 hour wear, okay, waterproof, smudge proof, and completely fade proof. So that's a lot of claims. That's some very, very big claims, and it's a dual ended type of product. So you have a liquid eyeliner at one side, and then you've got the pencil one on the other side. I think that is really smart, because then when you take it traveling, you just have to take the one product. And I'm really curious to see how it is going to perform. I think it's going to be okay, because Huda generally has good stuff, so I think it's going to be an okay product. But it's the same for me with Fenty. I can't get to Huda Beauty very easily when it comes to getting it in store, so I'm not going to be able to swatch it, see how the tip from the liquid liner is going to be, and I think that is really interesting and very important to me to know what type of formula is used on the Kohl pencil, and on the other hand the tip of the liquid liner, and if it's going to be a matte finish or it's going to be shiny or is it going to bleed on my hand already, so it's going to bleed on my eye. Yeah, so you see what I'm getting at. I'm not going to put this on the wish list because it's not very easy for me to get to it, and if I'm going to be in London I think it's going to be a bit wasteful for me because I seriously don't need more eyeliners. I have a lot of eyeliners, I just need eyeliners in more different colors. I'm working on that. I'm trying to get to my ColourPop order that's been ordered on the 4th of July. Still not here. Just pray for me that it's coming, because they're saying, no, you have to go to your carrier. Okay, fine, but okay, I digress. Huda. It's the same thing. I'm not going to get that because I've got like a lot of liquid liners, so I don't need no more liquid liners and I don't need more black Kohl eye pencils. But I think it's a very nice product all the same as a release. Then they also have a makeup remover balm. And I think it's more of a oil type balm. It has a whole lot of text. Whatever, it's going to be enriched with cherry blossom extract, so it's going to smell really nice, and you can actually remove the life liner, so that's a good thing, they say. And then yeah, that's something. I like a balm. I use the Take the Day Off balm from Clinique, so I really like that type of cleanser to start off with to break down my eye makeup. And yeah, so I already have something I really like. I'm not going to put this on the wishlist either. And there's also something that's called Hoodie Lash. And it's named after Huda's nickname. These are not for people that are shy. These lashes are not are for very confident people. Okay, sure. Well, the lashes are not shown in the photo, so I can't show you. Okay, we got something from ColourPop again. I think this has been talked about a lot already on the internet because it's been out for, I think, well, not a while, but a while for ColourPop standards. It's a peach palette and a peach collection, and it's going to include a Baby Got Peach palette for €12, for $12, a Peach Please Lip Tint Duo for $12. I think these are existing shades, they just put them in different packaging. You want a Peach of Me Super Shock set for $15, a Bellini BB lip bundle for $12, I'm doing good. The Fresh and Peachy Blush, Coral Peach Blush for $8, Frisky Business Blush, it's a light peach pink, for $8, a Perk Up Blush in a Neutral Nude for $8, and a Grand BFF Liquid Liner, that's a brown liner, for $8. And I must say, I don't hate this release. I have to say, I don't think I'm wearing the It's My Pleasure palette for the first time, finally, from ColourPop. So this is not something I usually wear. I'm not very much into the pink, into the purple tone. So I'm not sure really why I got this. I think that's because Mel Thompson was really raving about this one. Everybody was raving about this, but especially Mel. And I was like, okay, then I should get it. I should try it. And then I have some very nice purple eyeshadows, but I never wear purple eyeshadows. I don't really think it suits me that much. So yeah, that's why I never buy this. But I really like, especially for summer, but sometimes just for work, to make a very easy, light, fluffy look and just put some eyeliner on and I'm done. And I think this palette is perfect for that. So I think it's a very nice palette. I may pick it up in future, but I just want to wait until my ColourPop order is coming in, because I think it's ridiculous to wait that much and wait that long. And I am thinking about that now. I also have the Sweet Talk palette, so I want to see how much I can dupe from this palette to that palette, because otherwise it's going to be just wasteful to get the two of them. The Just a Tint lip crayons I just want to try, and I think these colors are really, really cute. And then the blushes also, I like the type of nudie type of colors. I really like those type of blushes, the more corally, almost bronzy, orangey type of peach colors. I really like that like those tones right now, so I'm really drawn into that. Then Super Shock shadows, they look really nice, but I don't need any more of those shimmery stuff. The lip balms and the lip scrub, yeah, well, you know. But the brown mascara and the brown eyeliner also look really, really intriguing. So I think this is a very cute, very fun look, or a launch. But I'm not going to put it on the wish list, mainly because I really have to find some trust back with ColourPop to see if they are really going to help me get my order here. Because I live in Holland, I have to order it from America. Normally it takes a few weeks to get here, that's fine, I don't mind. But yeah, now it's like, no, you have to just do that and find out for yourself. And I'm like, no. It's your problem if something I paid for is not arriving at my doorstep. So I first want to see what they're going to do about that. And then maybe I'm going to get this in the future, but I don't want to waste a spot on my wish list for this. Then, sort of ColourPop related, 4th Ray Beauty have launched a new mist. It's the Glisten Up Vitamin C Mist, and it looks so nice. I have no idea if it's going to be in a citrus type of scent, but it looks really, really nice. They say it's an instantly enhance your skin with a hydrated glow, infused with vitamin C, hyaluronic acid, camu camu, and white tea to support a radiant complexion. Microfine shimmer delivers a subtle glow. Just mist over skin and get glowing. Smells like sunshine in a bottle. Well, that sounds delish. And it's available now on 4th Ray Beauty for $12. It contains the vitamin C, hyaluronic acid, camu camu. It's a rich source of vitamin C and white tea. So yeah, this sounds really nice. It's just the same thing as the ColourPop thing. I'm not going to order anything that is ColourPop owned at the moment because I want to see if they can get it to me. But if I'm going to put in an order, I'm going to check out the mist because I think there are even more than just this one. And I love me a good face mist. So yeah, and some face mist that's $12. Sign me up. The next thing is definitely going on the wish list. Oh, even it's already, I think, on the wish list, but it's the new highlighters from Benefit. They have released Cookie and Tickle in singles. That's what I wanted to say. They have released Cookie and Tickle in singles. So you can get the separate highlighters now without having to buy a full palette. You can just get them as singles. And Mel Thompson, I am a big fan of Mel. I must say, I really love her. Yeah, she is over the moon with Cookie. It's her ultimate favorite highlighter at the moment. So I really, really want to try it. And I'm going to get it. It is available now on Sephora, but I think it's going to come to Holland in the next few weeks, I would imagine, because normally it doesn't take Benefit that long to spread out across the world, or at least not spread out to Holland. It doesn't take them very long. So it could be that it's already available for me, but I don't know for sure. I'm going to check. Yeah, and I'm going to get Cookie because it's already on my wish list, and I think that the Tickle highlighter looks really nice. It's a golden pink, but if I have to choose, I'm more into the goldeny champagne type of highlighters because it looks nicer on my skin tone, and I'm like, I don't really like a highlighter that is showing up that much. I just like a highlighter that is very glowy from within type of a color. And then if I put something pink on and it's going to be too pink, then it's just not my vibe. It's just no. But this is going on the wish list. Going over to Natasha Denona, she has released a new lipstick range, and she says that you guys know me for all my dramatic smoky eye makeup looks paired with nude lipstick shades. So I had to create nudes for everybody. Brand new lipstick formula in 18 new shades to suit everyone. Well, who can refuse a good nude? Really, they look stunning. There are two pictures, I'm going to put them both up. And I think for a nude lipstick, I am still looking for that perfect nude shade. Right now, I'm not wearing anything because I have a teeny, 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 teeny little little bit left of my eczema on my lips. So I think I'm going to get rid of that in the next week or so. So I can finally wear some lipsticks again, because that's just annoying. So I would say I'm not going to put them on the wishlist because I can't get to Natasha Denona in store in Holland. And I'm going to, as I said, to London. And I think in Selfridges they have Natasha Denona. So I hope they will be already there, because it's going to launch on the 26th of August. That's the day. And I want to see them in store, because I really want to see what is going to be my perfect nude. And I think I might buy one if I find it. But because I don't know for sure how I'm going to get to it, I am not going to waste a space on my wish list, because I think there are already like 24 products on there. I'm working on curating it a bit, because there's some stuff on there I'm like, do I still want this? Do I still need this? So I think I'm going to make a video about how my wish list is currently looking, and if I still want everything that's on there, and especially coming up to my London trip, what I want to get in London, so I can make sort of a London type wish list. And I think I'm just going to dedicate a video to that. So if you're interested in that, then please subscribe, so you will not miss that video. Moving on to Besame. Oh my god, this is... Oh my god, this is so dang cute. They have made a Sleeping Beauty Film Limited Edition collection, and it's now available on their website. It includes an eyeshadow palette, a vanity mirror. I think Besame has also made that Snow White mirror that Tati always uses. I don't even use a handheld mirror anymore, but that's the one I really, really want. And then an Aurora's translucent powder. It's a translucent powder to set your makeup. Briar Rose blush palette, a Locket Cream Rouge. And that is a treasured locket that looks like a book, holding a rosy pink cream rouge inside that can be easily applied to the cheeks or even the lips. That's cute. So you can wear it around your neck and just take it with you everywhere and not look like a nerd. Then the Sleeping Beauty Pink, that's a dreamy lipstick. Maleficent, an enchanting lipstick. And Make It Blue, Make It Pink, that's a magical color changing lipstick, which is blue but transforms to a pink shade once applied to the lips. And that, of course, refers to the scene where the two fairies, the blue one and the pink one, are trying to make her dress be the color they want. And that's funny, because it's blue. No, it's pink. No, it's blue. It's pink, pink. It's funny. It's cute. The thing is, with this type of stuff, it looks so great. And I'm going to... I don't have the pictures here, but I've seen them on Beauty News. So I'm going to try and put all the pictures I have from the palette and the products up here. This is just the photo you see. It's just an overview of all the products in here. Just a marketing photo, I would imagine. But the eyeshadow palette is a book. And the colors in the eyeshadow palettes are so stunning, because they are so true to the colors of the movie. And if it's a good formula, that's such a unique palette to have. So I'm really intrigued by it. I would love to have it, but I have no clue what the costs are, because maybe I'm going to try and look it up. Okay. Besame Cosmetics, Sleeping Beauty, 20 Shades. I'm going to see if I can find it on their website. This is a YouTube film. Okay, the vanity mirror is going to be 52.95 euros. The eyeshadow palette is 61.95. The Sleeping Beauty Pink lipstick, 21.95. The blush palette is going to be 31.95. The Aurora's translucent powder is going to be 16.95. The Make It Blue, Make It Pink lipstick is 21.95. The locket is going to be 16.95. Maleficent lipstick is going to be 21.95. You can get the complete Sleeping Beauty 1959 collection for 244.95 euros, or you can get the Royal Vanity and the eyeshadow palette for 114.95. I'm looking at it and I'm like, shall I get it? I got it. Okay, it doesn't need to go on the wish list because I just got it. Then I'm going to the Norvina palette by Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's the Norvina Volume 1. You know what I think is a bit weird? Why is it Norvina Volume 1? Is it because it's really just Norvina? And the last time it was Anastasia as well, because it's not... It's still ABH. But okay, well... Doesn't matter. Yeah, this palette, you know, the thing is, it's going to be $16 and it's launching today on their website. And I think it's going to just roll out through their retailers in the next few weeks, months, whatever. The thing is, what I was saying about the It's My Pleasure palette, I am not someone who really likes to wear that much purple. And this palette just screams purple. But if you look at it a little bit closer, then you see that it's really got only 1, 2, 3 really true purple colors. And the rest is just catered around that. It's very dark, I think. The colors are very, very vibrant. And I think there are also some pigments in here. Also, my dear Mel Thompson, I've seen video of her this morning using the kind of neon-y pinkish orange colors, and she made a very, very cool look with those. And she made something with the gold and the purples, and yeah. You know what I think is so difficult about this one? I really love ABH. I've got almost all the palettes, and I'm going to try if I can get it, the Jackie Aina palette as well, because I really think that's a cool palette. I've talked about it last week. I'm trying to link up the video right here. The thing is with this palette, it's so dark and it's a lot of colors. I'm like, I wouldn't even know how to pair this, because it's usually I can look at a palette and I'm like, yes, this is going to go really nicely together. This is going to be a look I want to create, that look I want to create. And with this, I'm like, what will I do? Where do I start? So even though I really think this is going to be quality wise great, because ABH has great eyeshadows, and they look really vibrant, and what I saw from Mel's video, they perform great on the eyes. I think I'm going to skip this, because I'm just not getting, like, this is an On a Crisp palette vibe from this. This is not something I will be reaching for a lot, and I think that's just wasteful to get it. But I think that if you want to get it, I would totally understand, because it looks stunning, and I think it's going to be quality wise really cool, really good. Sorry, cool. I think quality wise it's going to be a very good palette as well. It's just not something I am drawn to. This is not the type of colors I use or like to use, so yeah, I'm going to skip it. This one I am not going to skip. I am going to get this. It's the new Beth McGrath eyeshadow palette in the Mothership line, and it's the Mothership 6 Midnight Sun. She says, revel in nocturnal surrealism with 10 opulent hues that conjure the divinity of the midnight sun. A scintillating? I don't know. Solstice of color emerges as magical bronzes, wicked violets, mystical crimsons, and Goddess Gold's eclipse eyes with multi-dimensional effects and unprecedented single stroke intensity. I'm sorry, I can't read. Sometimes I'm really like, okay, you pack so much adjectives and so much words in just this very cramped space, and I'm like, okay, what are you saying exactly? It doesn't matter. It looks stunning. It is so stunning. And I will forgive the purple. I don't really like purples. But I think this purple is really nice, and you can combine it with the golds and stuff, so you can just have a little touch of it on your eyes, or you can just go ham, of course, if you want to. But what I love about this palette is the green, the Wicked Envy, and then with the Vermilion Venom. That combination, I think, is going to be so, so beautiful. And I think you've got a lot of neutrals, and you can make a very neutral look with this. You can make a very colorful look with this. So I think, yeah. The other one, the Mothership 5, I think, is also a palette that was like, okay, I'm intrigued by it, but somehow it didn't catch me that much. This one really caught me right off the bat. I think the first post I saw was on Instagram by Terrible Decisions, Tara from Terrible Decisions. She was like, no, I want to know by year she releases this palette. And I was like, just wait, hon, till you know by year is done and just get it. And I think she will. But I saw it and I was like, oh yes, I totally get why you would be sucked into this one right away, because the colors are so stunning, and I think that the shimmer shades are going to be so special again. So yeah, I want this on my wishlist. I'm going to put this on my wishlist, guys, and I hope that it will be already there, because it's launching at the 6th of September on Pat McGrath website, and it's going to be $125, the same as the other Marcia palette. And I hope it's going to be in time for me to see and swatch it in Selfridges, because I really, really want to get this in store. And if I can't get it in September, then I think I'm going to London around Christmas time anyway, so I am going to pick it up then. But yeah, this is something that's going on the wish list. Oh, I'm already on the last thing right now. It's also a Fenty Beauty release. I totally forgot to talk about it when I was talking about the other stuff, about the brow pencil, so you know, mind blown. I'm sorry. It's just that they have added 5 new shimmery match sticks shades. They have launched on the 23rd of August on Fenty Beauty, Sephora, Boots, Harvey Nichols, so you can get it. It's going to be in 5 colors. Cognac, that's a gilded chestnut. Peach Balm, that's a radiant peach. Pink Lemonade, that's a glimmering pink. And Champagne Heist, and glittering champagne.
Well done.
And Bordeaux Brat, that's a radiant berry. I would not know how these things perform on the skin, because I've never used them. They look really nice. I think the shades are really, really pretty. But I'm just going to skip, because I have, I think, now enough cream products to last me for a while. So this is just not something that is really piquing my interest. So yeah, but you know it's there. So if you like the matchsticks, then you can go get more if you want. Okay guys, that's it for this week. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you liked what you saw. And if you want to know every product that is on my wishlist at the moment, then just check out the description box. If you want me to start linking to the products I talk about, then please let me know. I will be able to do that. It's just going to be a lot more work. So I really want to know if you want me to do that, yes or no, because it's a lot of work. And I'm not going to put in the work if you don't even want to see that. So, okay, thank you so much again. And I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye.